Run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Why does the United States spend the largest percentage of GDP in the world on healthcare? Why do we have the highest cancer rates on the planet? The highest rates of diabetes, autism, and every other major disease? It all comes down to one thing. We are what we eat. Our food is devoid of nutrition and processed with poisons and additives. Our water is filled with toxic poisons and big pharma runoff. All of this has been engineered by design. We can turn the tide against the eugenicist by giving ourselves the nutrients our body desperately needs. To learn more, visit InfoWarsHealth.com. The site is literally packed with audio and video featuring top health professionals who don't bow down to Big Pharma. The fight against the New World Order starts with you, and you can't stand against the machine of your sick, tired, and obese. When you visit InfoWarsHealth.com, be sure and check out the catalog with nearly 400 life-changing products and get free shipping when you sign up for AutoShip. In the last 50 years, iodine has been phased out of our staple foods and replaced with the halogen bromine, a practice now banned in nations around the world. Guess what else is in the halogen family? Fluoride. Ladies and gentlemen, Alex Jones here. In 1924, the federal government did the right thing and encouraged salt producers to add iodine. It's the good halogen on the periodic table. And the results are on record, reports documented, a 15-point IQ increase in areas that had previously been deficient in iodine. Bottom line, iodine is important. Unbound, clean, in a glycerin base, nascent iodine was the answer for myself and my family. You will find Survival Shield Nascent Iodine exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWars Life Survival Shield Nascent Iodine isn't just for emergencies. I take it every day. That's InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. Introducing Pro One. All of your filtration in one system, portable, on the go. No more do you have two or three filters to just reduce sodium fluoride. You have a system that cuts out the sodium fluoride and up to 95% of hydrofluorosilicic acid. Advanced manufacturing technology combines silver impregnated white ceramic with new Aquamedics advanced media for removal of fluoride and other heavy metals, all in one filter element. It is the only one that does it, and out of the gate, we have it discounted at 10% off with promo code WATER. This is the only system that in one unit helps reduce or remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, ammonia, and chlorine, hydrofluorosilicic acid, the most common form of fluoride not covered by other fluoride filter brands, and sodium hexafluorosilicate. Get your Pro Pure with the new Pro One filters today at InfoWarsStore.com or by calling 888-253-3139.
We need to do this every day of the week and just really brainwash people into thinking about guns in a vastly different way.
It's not about keeping guns out of the hands of law-abiding Americans, and I'm sick and tired of people lying to the American people.
We can't have a totally armed society.
We're not proposing a gun registration system. We're proposing background checks for criminals.
In the spirit of gun control, will you disarm your entire security team?
We'll get right back to you.
You'll get back to me?
Hitler took the guns. Stalin took the guns. Mao took the guns. Fidel Castro took the guns. Hugo Chavez took the guns. And I'm here to tell you, 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms. Doesn't matter how many lemmings you get out there on the street begging for them to have their guns taken. We will not relinquish them. Do you understand?
The answer to 1984 is 1776. You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
The senator from New York, Chuckie Schumer, coming out and saying he wants to get a law passed to take plastic emulsifiers, silicone derivatives out of the Subway bread and other fast food breads. Yes, every other country in the world has banned the petrochemicals from being put in there. We launched last Tuesday with the Food Babe that initiative. You, as our listeners, took action and were a big part of that victory. So I salute you. And you notice now the other fast food makers are falling like dominoes, saying they're going to pull out that chemical or similar chemicals. There's a whole family of them. I mean, it was on CNN 10 years ago that McDonald's nuggets have silicone in them. Our FDA says it's okay for melamine to be in baby formula. They execute you for that in China. I mean, this is a big deal. There's a reason we have the highest diabetes, the highest cancer, because we're a dumping ground for toxins. Now, I bring that up because we have the NSA and the things that is going on with it. And there is the daywefightback.org, which is nonpartisan. That's what I like, trying to get left, right, center libertarians like ourselves together from across the political spectrum to say no. And this is coming up in 10 hours, and everybody's going to put a banner on their website. I'm going to put it in some of our rotating banners for everybody to say, no, we don't want the NSA spying on us. We're aware of what's happening. And you see states like Maryland moving to turn off the power to the NSA, New Mexico, Utah is looking at that. What they're doing is illegal. And they want to divide us on race, religion, culture, liberal, conservative on this issue of the NSA. It's the Fourth Amendment. That's what I always tell establishment leftists who really believe in gun control because they're ignorant, is if they can take your Second Amendment, they're going to take your First, which they're doing. So we stand up for everybody's First Amendment, everybody's Second, Fourth, Fifth, Tenth. That's what it's all about. And so joining us is Nathan White, Washington representative for Demand Progress. And I appreciate you coming on. Tell us about the initiative you guys are launching now. You've had some other initiatives that have been successful around the Bill of Rights and what people can do to help promote awareness.
Well, first of all, thanks for having me on the show. I really appreciate your attention to this important matter and appreciate you participating in February 11th, the day we fight back against mass surveillance.
Well, tell us about it. Yeah.
So last summer, we found out we had confirmation of what we've been hearing for a long time. The government is spying on us. It's a matter of fact. The government is spying on us. If you use a computer, if you use a telephone, if you use any sort of modern system of communication, the government is spying on you. That's a problem. You just said it. It's a violation of the Fourth, and I would argue also the First Amendment of the United States Constitution. When the government does that, it's going too far. And when it violates the Constitution, that isn't a left-right issue. The Constitution is the thing that holds the left and the right together.
They're trying to chill free speech. Exactly. They're trying to chill free speech. So it is an attack on free speech as well. You're right.
So we've got together, and we wanted to take a moment to bring everyone together to speak with one voice to say, no, this is not okay, and this has got to stop. And we chose February 11th as the day we fight back. The website's thedaywefightback.org. And we have a really broad coalition from everybody from Greenpeace and ACLU all the way to the Libertarian Party and Campaign for Liberty and Freedom Works. We've got corporations, we've got websites, we've got activists, we've got thought leaders, we've got everybody, because everybody understands that this is a problem. It cannot continue, and it's up to us to take this moment to make sure it stops.
Tell us about the initiative and how folks can promote it.
Well, the website is thedaywefightback.org. That's where you can get into the network and sign up to participate. So far, we have almost 5,500 websites, some huge, some small, willing to participate, that they're going to host a banner saying today is the day we fight back and ask you to participate. We already have tens of thousands of internet users who have signed on to participate. And what that means is really open up to you. We have a widget where you can put in your address and your zip code, and it will tell you the phone number of your senator and your members of Congress, so you can call and say, no, stop this. I don't want this. But we're also encouraging people to go further. The internet is such a dynamic, interesting place because it's millions of people working together to do whatever the hell they want. And this is that opportunity of, you know, you are the hero. This is your story. This is your internet. This is your fight. Do what you think. You know, some people are going to have creative tweets. We're asking people to put together memes, put posts on the internet, to do whatever they can, whatever they feel comfortable with, to do what they can. And at the very least, we're also asking people to go ahead and call Congress, because at the end of the day, we are going to need Congress to do something.
And absolutely.
And Congress to do anything is tough.
Exactly. And I love some of the groups on there. Some of them not so much. Doesn't matter. It's about getting in the habit of working together. It's about getting in the habit of agreeing on what we can agree with each other. It's about getting in the habit of getting outside the left-right paradigm and saying, hey, there's things that everybody agrees on. The NSA, over 90% are upset. But that doesn't even matter. It's illegal No free society does this. The government, Bush and now Obama, have been caught lying about what's happening. Clapper committed perjury, saying that they're not spying on us when it's on record. What else don't we know? How deep does it go? And we need to have solidarity with all these states across the country that are moving to block this as well, to literally culturally create a stigma around Big Brother type activities.
You know, there are so many different reasons why this is wrong. You just outlined some great reasons why we need to stand up for civil liberties. But this is one of those interesting cases where doing what's right for business is also what's right for the common good. Right now, one of the most innovative job creators we have is the internet. It allows the smallest corporation to compete against the biggest corporation. It allows Netflix to dethrone Blockbuster, and it allows any sort of competition between the smallest and the largest. But when we shut that down and we don't have that open ability to communicate, then we end that innovation. We're seeing that most particularly in the future of cloud computing, where we're seeing our overseas partners, they're afraid to do business with American corporations because they don't want Uncle Sam reading their email. When a company says, I'm losing tens of millions, perhaps ultimately billions of dollars, because our partners, our friends in our allied countries, even in Europe, don't want to do business with us, not only are we violating the civil liberties, but we're also violating the business community. And that brings another aspect into this, and it's another ally between businesses, the right, the left, the middle. Everybody who is aware of what's going on is against it. And we're asking people tomorrow, February 11th, to say, this is the day we fight back. This is the day where we're all going to speak with one voice. So if you're listening, check out the website, thedaywefightback.org. See what you want to do. See how you can participate, but also sign up. Call your members of Congress tomorrow. Also, let your friends know you're participating. If you're on Facebook, change your images, post status updates. Do whatever you can to let people know that this is not okay and we're going to have to stop it.
You know, the establishment is really scared right now, Nathan, and I know you've got your finger on the pulse as well, so I want to get your take on this briefly. But when I talk to members of Congress, Democrats, Republicans, independents, you name it, they say, no doubt, the public's the most awake, the most angry we've ever seen. Across the board, 9% approval rating now has gone to 6% for Congress. That's why they're trying to up the partisan politics, is to, you know, desperately make us think that we're not really together on most issues. But this has got to really scare the establishment that we're forcing a conversion to take, you know, the different BPA out of the plastics. We're forcing a conversion to organic food. We're forcing... just across the board, when people get involved, we have victories.
Well, you know, I some of your listeners may not agree with this, but I do still claim to be a Democrat. But I recognize that in the two-party system, you know, the only winners and losers are the parties. That we don't elect a color blue or color red to represent us. We represent people to represent us. And those people need to be more than ideology. They need to be more than just a machine that wants to get promoted within the party structure. They need to be people that have our interests at heart, and they need to represent those interests. And if they don't, they've got to go, whether they're left, right, red, or blue. They've got to go if they're not working for us. But when you look at USA, or when you look at the surveillance, there's a bill in Congress called the USA Freedom Act, which actually on the House side has more than 150 co-sponsors. And the most interesting thing about it is it's bipartisan. This isn't a Republican bill. It isn't a Democrat bill. It's that people who look at this realize it's illegal, realize that people are against it, they come together. And that actually gives me a lot of hope that, you know, sometimes when the people are outraged, when we get together, when we fight back together, left, right, brother and sister, we can still make a difference. And that's why I'm so passionate about making sure we do the best we can tomorrow.
Absolutely. It's very exciting. Nathan White, thank you so much for spending time with us, and we'll get some updates in the aftermath.
All right. Well, I really appreciate it, and thanks for all you do.
You bet. Thank you. TheDayWeFightBack.org. And folks, expanding on that, even if, and we're going to send them an image, they're going to put our little logo up there as well. Here's the issue. Just like the Second Amendment, we're pushing back against the establishment, reaching out to the left. The so-called Democrats I know in the last 5 years have been out buying guns. There's a paradigm shift that's happening right now, and that's why we reach out to these people, is that there are people in the system, in the left and the right, who are not just automatons, who do want freedom. And the last thing the establishment wants is anybody working together. They want balkanization.